If you're working in the software industry, you have probably heard of vector stores. What are these vectors? They're representations of objects which you would traditionally store in a relational or NoSQL database. Now, instead of storing the rows and the columns or all of that text information, you try to condense this information into a single point in an n-dimensional space. That's what's called a vector. It's a 1D array of size n. The reason vectors have become so popular is because you can tell how similar two vectors are based on the distance between them. So if I take the words apple, banana, and nuclear weapons, you'll expect apple and banana to be close to each other and nuclear weapons to be quite far. Now imagine the use cases of this database. If I look at nearby objects when a person is browsing on Amazon for a particular product, I can suggest those objects as recommendations to the person. Instead of using error-prone techniques of frequency or word count, I can now just have a complex context-aware vector which will tell me all the nearby objects which are similar to it. That's the reason why you're seeing enormous amounts of funding go to teams which are trying to build efficient vector stores. It has a huge impact on the industry. If you're looking to learn more about vector databases and similar topics, you can subscribe to this channel. I'll see you next time.